Welcome to DIY Solar and Wind. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. Please subscribe and then click that little bell that's not in the video. You'll see all my upcoming videos. I've got about 107 videos in 7 months. How to take the house off-grid, one solar panel at a time. I got the professional crimpers in for the 4-aught cable. That's a monster. But that's the monster. So you don't want to pay $10 for this, $10.50. So go get some copper tubing that'll fit over the end of your 4-aught cable. So you don't need to be spending $10.50. But make sure, just like the rings here, you're supposed to crimp it in two places. And a lot of the professional off-grid are talking about soldering. That's the only way, because sometimes they might be corroded like 10 years later and you're not going to make the same connection as you used to, so you got to solder it anyway. But just thought I'd throw that quick tip out there. You got the crimpers and I'm going away for a week, and so we'll see what happens. I still got to wire in the brand new battery bank. I gotta figure out how that switch gets tied in. I showed you on the last one, but it was inside the container then. For battery bank 1, battery bank 2, I gotta rewire the whole system. It's not gonna be like having one battery bank. It's a little bit more complex, I think. But then, I'm probably gonna go ahead and use this charge controller. And then we got to figure out a little bit to do with that. I got the wiring schematic. There's one completely different from the solar, the wind, or both, solar and wind. There's three different wiring schematics. So this charge controller has been around for a little bit, but I never had to use it. Now I'm going to, because I'm going to need another charge controller. That'll be the fourth one sending all that electricity right into the great big battery bank. All right, that'll be it for now. Have a nice sunny day.